And Logan Tanner was the guy that broke up the perfect game for Jonathan Cannon with a double. Mississippi State program out of George County High School. And he sends this one into the gap. No one's going to catch it. It's going to hit and roll to the wall. And Tanner, who had a double to break up the perfect game for Jonathan Cannon last night, gets a double here to get the first hit of the day. And that is hit to right field. Could be trouble and high off the wall. Tanner scores easily, second double of the inning as Hines slides in, and Mississippi State has a 1-0 lead. And a four-pitch walk to Kellum Clark.
Way after they pull it foul.
1-1 is hit into center field. It's going to drop down in front of Ben Anderson, and the bases are loaded.
Somebody not named Cannon the next day.
And it gets away from Collins. Here comes the runner from third. He will score without a throw. Everybody else moves up 90 feet. And it's 2-0 as Hines touches the plate. 3-2. That ball is hit in the air. Left field. Connor Tate should score the runner from third. Way back there at the track. And he crashes into the wall. Tripped up and fell into the wall. They're going to try a double tag. And now they're going to hold the runner at third as Clark touches the plate. Cumbus thought about coming around third and scoring on a double tag, or a two-base tag, if you will. And it's 3-0 Mississippi State.
Yeah, great.
Ball rifled to the second baseman. Acton will throw him out, and the inning comes to a close. But a productive inning for Mississippi State. And a four-pitch walk to the number nine hitter, Corey Acton. First bump in the road for Stinnett.
Hot.
1-2, rifles it over his head into right field. That's going to score Acton from second base. A long RBI single for Corey Collins gets Georgia on the board here in the third. Runner goes, doesn't matter. Ball four, first and second for Georgia. Team batters. Wagner hits it on the ground right into the shift. Second baseman Yeager, low throw. And they get the out there as Wagner had to hurdle Hancock to avoid a conclusion. 3-1 pitch. Walked him on five pitches. In program history, two highest strikeout totals. Another walk here for Polk. 1-1 pitch. Ball is hit in the hole between first and second. Here comes Forsyth. He's going to score without the throw. Throw did go all the way through, not even close. And it's 4-1 Mississippi State. Davis goes to third. Runners at the corners. RBI for James. Umpires know the stats?
Oh, yeah.
2-2. Hit on the ground. Slow roller. Could be trouble. Rogers slips and falls down. He's safe. Run scores. Davis comes home from third. And it's 5-1. Tough luck right there for Georgia on a slow roller from Hancock. 3-2. Got him. Big strikeout for Michael Polk. Retiring perhaps the most dangerous batter in the Mississippi State order. Everything but the candles burning. I mean, it was great. Blaylock heads to first. Walked five, but he's been able to work around it. That could be two. And it hit Blaylock on top of the helmet and ricochets into left field. So he'll be safe at third.
Heads up baseball there by Blaylock.
1-0 pitch. And McAllister sends this one into the outfield. That should score Blaylock easily. And it will. Throw will not even come towards the plate. Sack fly RBI for McAllister. Blaylock touches home. And it's 5-2. And a walk to Acton. Walk number six for Stinnett. RBI performance, two-run homer last night. Four-pitch walk for Anderson. Walk number seven for Stinnett. Let's see last night's win. 1-1 pitch. On the ground, cue shot. It's going to roll through the shift into center field for a base hit. Two-run score. Georgia back in the game. Just a little cue jam shot right through the hole in the shift.
playing is a tough thing to watch.
Connor Tate sends this one up the chute to right field. Should be the final out of the inning. And a little bit bigger battle than I thought. The story of Chandler Marsh and how he's making his SEC debut. Just got dinged up a little bit right there. What a blast off the bat of Clark. Sent it up on the hill. And Kellum Clark says, freshman Chandler Marsh, welcome to the SEC. Solo home run for Clark, and it's 6-4 Mississippi State.
Yeah, really swinging a hot bat as Clark was robbed on a line shot by Garrett Blaylock in his previous at bat. There goes big fly, gets it over the wall.
And line drive base hit. First hit of the series for McAllister, even though he drove in a run with a sac fly as last time up, and then beat Mississippi State last night. Right back to the pitcher, and bobbled by the shortstop. Forsythe was trying to make the play and keep his foot anchored on the bag. 1-2 pitch. Bounced in there, gets away, racing home is McAllister, and it is 6-5, and now Acton is at third base. 2-2, hit in the right field, base hit, game tied 6-6. Cole Tate comes up big again, an RBI single. Conn to the plate, ball four, first and second, go ahead run in scoring position. Mississippi State out of this inning. Won't do it like that, bases loaded. Goes right after the first pitch. Solid single to right. One in. Collins gets the stop sign at third. Georgia on top, 7-6. Parks Harbor delivers the go-ahead single. To try to get out of this mess. Ball is hit down the line in left field. Long run and over the head of the left fielder, Cumbus. Going to clear the bases. A three-run double for Chaney Rogers. Georgia leads 10-6.
But I think the wind kind of kept it in the field of play, and it came back into the field. And you can see, looks at the wall right there last second, and it just kind of overran it. Bad, I thought it was going to be a foul ball.
McAllister shoots it to the third baseman, James. They get the out there. And that will end the inning.
Doubts.
Hancock sends this one down the line. Could be trouble if it's fair, and it is. Going to land on fair territory out there. Dwight Allen, who's now taken over in right field, gets it in, but that's a leadoff double by Hancock. Well, to try to navigate. And Tanner aboard. Down four. Ball four, bases loaded. Came in Monday's win. And he hits this one to deep left field. They may have gotten it. Jaegerbaum. Grand slam. We're tied at 10. How about that?
Wow. What a moment right there. Jaeger, bottom of the order, coming through again for Mississippi State.
RJ Jaeger with the Jaeger bomb, a grand slam that ties the score at 10 as we head to the seventh inning stretch. He's driven in three runs today. He's been on base four times. Cranks this one to deep center field. Going back, and it's gone. Corey Collins just put Georgia back on top with a solo blast to center field. His 15th career home run. Georgia leads. One, two. That ball is out of here. We're tied. Cumbus just redeemed himself with a monster blast into the parking lot. Oh my goodness. And he admired it as it went out. We're tied at 11. Here's Yeager, who hit a grand slam, and that handcuffs McAllister at third base. And so Yeager is aboard. The go-ahead run at first now. 0-1 from Woods. That is blooped in the left field. That's going to fall for a base hit. Go-ahead run now at second as Davis delivers. 3-0 pitch from Gowan. 4-pitch walk for Gowan out of the bullpen. Bases loaded. That ball is hit to center field. Ben Anderson ranging to his right, runs it down. Inning comes to a close. But we are tied at 11.
Strikes.
And a base hit. Chaney Rogers delivers a single to start the ninth. Tuller comes to the plate with a 3-2 pitch, walked him, first and second. First pitch, it rolls away from Tanner. Everybody moves up 90 feet. Now the winning run is at third base. And I think they're going to walk Anderson to load the bases.
Yeah, I was going to say, I think that's the right move, 2-0 in that situation.
Here's the 2-1 pitch. That is a base hit. Georgia wins. Cole Tate with his fourth career walk-off scores Chaney Rogers. Georgia wins it 12-11, and they have clinched this SEC opening weekend series.
And Coach Strickland, 600th career win. What a way to do it.
Absolutely. In grand style, Strick gets that number 600 of